Welcome to this short video where I will introduce you to making your first Endnote library and also orientate you around the Endnote program. When you first open Endnote, you'll need to create a new or open an existing library. So we go to File and then New. From the dialog box which opens, you'll be able to create your Endnote library and choose the location where you want to save it. I've made a folder in my Documents folder called Endnote Libraries, where you can see I've got lots of existing Endnote libraries. If this is the first time you have used Endnote, you won't have any in there. You can choose a name for your Endnote library. And you can see this is going to save as a .enl file. And you'll also notice in the library that for every .enl file, there is also an associated .data file. And those two files need to stay together. Click Save, and Endnote will open up your brand new Endnote library. So I'm going to maximize our view just so I can talk you through the different panels we can see here. So as with most applications, you've got various menus which perform different functions, and we also have a toolbar that runs along the top. I'm not going to talk through absolutely everything on the toolbar, just the key ones that we're going to use in this and subsequent videos. The first thing I want to mention is the integrated library and online search mode. I would recommend that you click on the icon on the toolbar, which looks like a tiny little globe icon inside a folder. Once you've clicked on there, you will see all of the references and groups and online search options all in the same panel on the left hand side. Next along the toolbar, we have a drop down menu, which will probably say something like annotated. This is where you can choose the output style for your references. There are many different referencing styles out there. You might be using Harvard or Chicago or Vancouver and so on. This is where you can choose your referencing style. I'm going to choose the Harvard Lancaster University Library style. Don't worry if you don't yet have that style in your library. A later video will show you how to get that in there. It's worth knowing that there are hundreds of output styles in Endnote already loaded. So if you can't see your preferred style in a list, then choose Select Another Style and you will see the full list. The next most important icon on the toolbar is the New Reference icon, which again we'll cover in a different video. So every panel in Endnote can be dragged across and resized to make it the size that you wish. So you can resize depending on the size of the monitor or laptop screen that you're using. The slightly bluish grey panel on the left hand side gives you a rundown of everything inside your library. So you can see we have a list of all references and various commands down the side. We have the trash bin as well. We also have a section called My Groups, and this is where we can group different references together. That might be according to different topics, different chapters, different paragraphs. It could be for different assignments. That's entirely up to you. To create a new group, you can go to the menu at the top where it says Groups and choose Create Group, or you can right click on My Groups in the list on the blue panel and click Create Groups, and you can give yourself your group a name. I'm going to name this group Child Soldiers because we're going to gather some references on that topic during these videos. Further down on this panel you can see online searches, and these permit us to search bibliographic databases and library catalogues. And finally, there's a full text option, which again we'll cover in another video. Okay, so moving into the middle, at the top of the main panel here, we have the search panel, and this is contains various search boxes for you to search within your list of references. So as you're building up a large database of references, you can locate quickly the ones that you want by author, year, title, or any of the other fields in your references. The main body of the window here in the middle is where you will start to see, as you add references, a table of all the references in your library building up. Within each group as well, once you select a group, you will see a different set of references appearing in the middle here. Essentially, this is just a table, like in any database or spreadsheet, and you can resort references by clicking on the headers at the top, and you can also choose different headers to display at the top by right-clicking and choosing a different field of the database to show in your table. But we'll just leave it on the default for now. And over here on the right, this is the reference window. So as we start adding references, you will see all of the different fields, such as title, author, date, journal title, and so on, appearing over here in the right. There is also a preview tab, where once we have some references in, we will see a preview of the reference formatted in your chosen style. And if you do end up attaching any PDFs or full text to your references in Endnote, you will also see them previewed here under the next tab. Okay, so we're about ready to start collecting references, so you can move on to the next video. Thanks for watching.